Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Colin.
Hello, everybody. This is Cecilia. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Hey Cecilia, where were you yesterday?
Oh, I've been to a friend's wedding.
Again?This is like the third wedding you've been to this month.
Yeah, I don't know why. All of a sudden, everyone is getting married.
Soon you'll find everyone is having a child.
Not this one, at least. She's not planning to have kids. 她是丁克族，不打算要小孩哈。那丁克族的这个丁克呢，其实是由 think 这个英语单词音译过来的。Think 就是 double income, no kids 的首字母组成的。
Yeah, well, I find that more and more young people are starting to think about not having any children.
Yeah, China's middle class has grown and prospered in recent years. But its members often worry about the future, their own and their children's.
好像现在大家对于要不要生孩子这件事情会考虑的更多了哈。一方面呢，现在更加开放自由了一些。那另一方面，大家也会对当下的这个环境有一个考量。到底现在适不适合生孩子呢?
Yeah, especially those with appalling news causing anxiety and anger. No wonder more people choose not to have kids.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. The scandals of alleged child molestation at a RYB kindergarten, right? 是最近刚刚爆出来的那个男幼师骚扰幼童的新闻是吧?这个 child molestation 是我们说的非常恶劣的这种行为哈,叫做猥亵儿童。
Right.Has prompted public outrage.
这种事情肯定是会引起公愤的。那 public 是公众的 ,outrage 表示愤怒。那所以呢 ,public outrage 就是我们说的公愤。
It's hard to look at these things. But by talking about it, hopefully we may be able to bring parental soul searching, government pledges, and online censorship.
对,这个话题虽然聊起来比较揪心哈,但是呢,通过讨论或许哈，我们可以引起家长的一些反思啊，也可以去引导政府去建立更完善的监管制度。那刚刚说了一个词叫做 soul searching， 就是我们说的反思、反省。那我们的内容都整理成了文字版的笔记，欢迎大家到微信搜索“早安英文”，私信回复“笔记”两个字来领取我们的文字版笔记。其实这个事情最恶劣的点在哪儿呢？在于这个男友是他完全就是利用了孩子的这种天真无邪，他让这个小朋友去闻他的脚，还把照片发在网上，这个目的就很不单纯啊。
Yeah, you know, kids may not be able to tell if there's anything unusual. The boys may think that they're only playing.
Right. Not only the kid, even the kid's mother believed that it was only a game at first.
这个孩子的妈妈一开始也只以为他们只是在玩游戏而已，就没有去过多的在意。
But obviously, it's only a pretense.
那很明显，这就是一个借口哈。那借口或者说托词，我们就可以说是 pretense.
Yeah. And as a result, RYB issued a statement saying the teacher has been fired. The company also said it would uphold a zero tolerance policy towards child abuse.And shoulder responsibilities pending the result of the police investigation.
红黄蓝教育机构对此事做出的回应就是说，他们已经辞退涉事教师了。他说，对于这类问题，他们是零容忍的态度。那零容忍，我们就可以说是 zero tolerance.
However, many internet users have angrily rejected this response as inadequate.And they're calling for severe punishment for the teacher.
Yeah, I totally understand why people feel that way. Because same things happen again and again. Before this, four RYB teachers had been each sentenced to more than 2 years in prison for abusing more than 20 children.
Right. It's this great sense of insecurity that the parents are facing right now. They call for new legislation and a coordinated nationwide effort to monitor and control perpetrators of crimes against children.
确实，我们需要集合社会的力量去监管这些针对儿童的罪犯啊。 那这个 perpetrator 就是我们说的犯罪者、行凶者。
So, another thing. Better education and more support are also needed to encourage victims and their parents to report offenses.
完全赞同哈。那就说到了 education 这个点啊。无论是来自学校的呢，还是来自家长的，我相信正确的性教育都是孩子抵御侵犯的第一道屏障哈。
A lack of sex education for children contributed to the problem as youngsters did not know how to protect themselves when assaulted. As the boy in this case, he did not know he was being sexually assaulted.
Yeah, especially when the cases of child molestation were committed by school faculty.
Right, because kids usually take no precautions against people they believe are kind.But this may also be a source of danger.
是的，这种来自教职工的侵害其实是最难防范的哈，因为孩子天性就会信任他们，对他们是一点防备心都没有哈。那我们说的 take precautions against somebody something， 它表示预防某事，去防备某事。
So this makes education necessary and urgent. At least, children should be taught how to protect themselves from sex attacks.
But in practice,Sex education has been controversial since some worry it will stimulate children's curiosity. In some places, it is even considered taboo in China. 现在中国的性教育推广还是面临着重重的阻力哈。在某些地方呢，大家甚至还是很忌讳对孩子谈这些。那 taboo 就是我们说的忌讳的、禁忌的。
Well, for example, cancer is also a taboo subject.
Yeah, fortunately, we have witnessed that some cities have started a course on self-protection to keep children from falling victim to sexual assault. Those schools wanted to tell the kids, this is a beautiful world, but there are bad things.
Yeah, they really should do that. Because one single case of molestation might make a child suffer for a lifetime. Look, as a father, I feel obligated to offer such education.
Obligated 就是有责任的,有义务的。Well, I feel obligated to share some useful knowledge with our listeners here. 那这里呢，跟大家分享一下由这个教育专家彭晓慧提出来的性教育的时间的一个节点，分享给大家。
According to the professor, sex education should begin from a child's birth. Between 0 and 3, children should be given gender and health education.
就是说，从这个出生到三岁这个阶段啊，孩子就可以开始了解性别和健康方面的知识了。
And between 4 and 9, children should be given sex safety education and basic sexual physiology education.
四岁到九岁之间呢，孩子们就应该开始接受这个性安全教育，以及了解这个基本的生理知识了。
Now over 10, children should be taught how to deal with the opposite sex.
十岁以上的孩子啊，就要开始学习如何与异性相处了。
I really hope kids could be equipped with the knowledge that they need to know and be protected from being hurt in the future.
没错哈，孩子呢是我们这个社会良知的最后底线。那我们孩子的家长在期待更完善的社会监管体系建立的同时，也可以尽我们所能去教孩子们如何保护自己哈。希望在未来不会再有孩子受到伤害了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So thanks for listening, everyone. This is Colin.
This is Cecilia. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.